You've got mail. Popful mail, that is. Heyo! That's probably the most 90s sentence that has ever been spoken.
Hey! What are you doing? You can't just leave me here!
Don't worry. God will come back for you sometime. Somehow. Someday. Maybe.
Yeah, I would probably be ambivalent about that too. So, we are getting pretty far into this game. We are almost through the Icy Cow area, and then after this there's only one more area to go. You know, I really like this music, but I wish they went with something a little bit more foreboding for this area. It's kind of a dark, almost spooky looking place. Spooky's not the right word, but like, you know the hidden palace level from Sonic and Knuckles? That's what this, I kinda get that vibe.
So you think you're tough, eh? Beat a couple of second rate babes and now you think you're hot stuff. Hand over the orbs or cash it in for good.
Reality check. Think about it. You're a penguin. I could roast you with my spit.
You don't know who you're dealing with. Let me show you something!
I could roast you with my spit. Not roast you on a spit. That's a very important distinction. So like last time, I'm going to leave and save before I fight this boss. Hopefully I shouldn't need it. This boss, it's not too bad.
You'll never get the blue orb.
That's my impression of that guy. Alright, so this boss, he basically just has one attack. It's a lightning attack that kind of goes along the floor. It's really easy to jump over, but, you know, everyone makes mistakes. You can hit this guy from the front or the back, but not when his eye is closed. And that's it. That is all there is.
Mighty Overlord, give me the power yet once more to crush the opposer.
Oh shit. Second form. Things are getting heavy now. So this boss basically has three attacks. He has that, and you cannot hit that bolt, or you can't hit it with your attack or let it pass over your head. You have to jump over it, which is why Gaul is the best choice for this fight. And then he has that little laser beam that's, you know, you shouldn't ever be that close to him, so it shouldn't be a problem. And he has that, which it pushes you back, but that's it. I don't really see what the point of that attack is, but, you know, I'm not going to complain. I kind of like this boss. It's more like a real boss fight than some of the other bosses. You know, it's not super challenging, but it's not so hard that the only way to beat it is by standing in one place and cheesing it the whole time. But yeah, still not super challenging. The Draguin. Ooh la la, Mr. Frenchie.
Defeated! No matter. The last orb awaits at the Overlord's palace. You will not be so fortunate there.
Alright.
Oh, thank you, thank you, thank you! Your persistence has wiped the scum from our fair kingdom.
But we couldn't have done it without your help!
As king of the land, I, Lips Naton, proclaim that you shall have whatever you request.
Fish heads, ooey gooey fish heads, God would like some fish heads, yum yum yum!
Say, how about a nice new aura weapon instead?
Thanks anyway.
If you're headed to the orb tower, be extra careful. It's jam-packed with some big freaking monsters.
Guy's very strong. No worries. Except that stupid elf kid.
I heard him say something about silver as he ran toward the orb tower.
Uh-oh. Something tells me this means trouble. Again. Gah.
Well, we must excuse ourselves now. After all, we have a country to rebuild. Thanks again for all your help.
Woohoo!
Cutscene.
We've managed to collect 3 of the 4 orbs. Only 1 remains.
That's right. And the imposter said it was up there, in the orb tower on Creepy Crag.
We'd better hurry.
Wow, Tad, I'm impressed. This is a side of you I've never seen. You're back. So, first we get the orb, then we fix the seal.
If we live that long.
Everything is proceeding according to plan, Master. They are almost ready to spring your trap.
They mustn't suspect a thing.
If they knew that replacing the orbs would complete our return, they would resist.
But if we replace the orbs, they will be destroyed, so we must rely on them. Kazer, you will see that they do not fail.
Consider it done, Master.
The day our fetters fall from us is close at hand. Soon all will learn the power of the Overlord.
Wow. So yeah, we're on the home stretch, guys. I bet a lot of you never thought we'd make it this far. I know I sure didn't. So wow, aura weapons. These weapons are all really cool. Obviously, they deal the most damage, and, you know, they are... Oh.
Why have you come to desecrate my sanctuary?
Is someone there? Someone nice? Gah!
I am Kazer, servant to the Overlord.
It's the guy from the cutscene.
Again, why do you defile our castle with your cowardly breath?
I was just testing out a new weapon.
I've come for the last orb, but I, don't suppose you're here to help me with that, are you? Ah.
Fool. My keep is for true believers, and you fall far short of the mark.
You're right. I'm here to stop you and your fanatical followers. Once I get the last orb, you'll be history, floaty pants.
On the contrary, I and my masters are the future of this forlorn world.
If you say so, buddy. Okay, so yeah, like I was saying, aura weapons. They are all really cool and powerful and all that. We got one for every member of the party. You know, best weapon in the game. And they are all kind of just straightforward projectile weapons. Which is kind of a bummer after the weapons where you could, you know, aim where the projectile goes and all that. But, I think they'll work out. Even Tats, just kind of a straightforward fireball. So yeah, the Freaky Foyer, or Foyer, I never know how you're supposed to pronounce that. We're almost there, guys. I don't know how many more episodes it'll be, but not a whole lot. I hope you guys have enjoyed so far, and I hope you tune in on Wednesday for more Popful Mail. See you guys later.